Ever wonder what it takes to be a great drummer? Let's find out next on Music Surgery with Dr. Bob. Music Surgery with Dr. Bob, where we cut into all kinds of musical topics, we diagnose the problem, we remedy the problem, and then we stitch it back up. Today's patients, all you drummers that wonder what it takes to be a great drummer, let's get busy and go to work on you. Sumner and I have compiled a list of questions frequently asked by drummers, so let's start out by answering a few of these to get some real clarity. Do I need to learn the rudiments to be a great drummer? Absolutely. Can I be a great drummer without learning the rudiments? Absolutely. Do I need to learn how to read to be a great drummer? Without a doubt. Can I be a great drummer if I don't know how to read? Without a doubt. Do I need to learn to play brushes to be a great drummer? For sure. If I don't know how to play brushes, can I be a great drummer? For sure. If the answer is yes to all these questions, then where's the truth? Well, the truth goes something like this. Dave Grohl probably wouldn't be the best fit for the Buddy Rich Orchestra, and Buddy Rich probably wouldn't sound great on Monkey Rich. Both great drummers, but what makes them tick is totally different. So let's look at some great drummers and their approach to music, and what makes them great. But before we watch these clips, I'm well aware that the drummers on here have more attributes to their playing than what we're showing. But for the purposes of this video, I'm just going to single out specific parts of their playing that perhaps are the parts of what they're known for and is the centerpiece of their career. Go! Are you hearing that these guys are playing with incredible speed and complexity, but that it's so precise that you can hear every stroke? Also, they're in complete control when most of this is probably improvised in the moment, where they have no idea what they're going to play in the next second.
Amazing. It's absolutely amazing.
drummer.
Great look, good drummer, good, yeah. Good. Notice these guys are laying down a groove that any bass player, guitar player, or keyboard player would love falling into. There's no guesswork where the next kick drum or snare drum falls. Everything is so relaxed and precise that it creates a landscape that just feels good to hear.
I feel nothing but pride from that track. That was one of the best tracks I ever played on. Now you probably realize the key here is the command these guys are playing with that could cut through any wall of guitars in a mix or a live show. They may be playing hard, but as I've said in other categories, it's so precise, there's no guesswork where the next kick drum or snare drum falls.
I'm hearing something really powerful.
Ow! Now! The big, 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 big question. The triplet. We all know about the triplet. We know that the triplet represents 12-4. We also know that it represents 12-8, too.
You're probably thinking these beats are relatively easy to play, but not like these guys are playing them. Listen deeper. Their time and internal metronome feels so good, and again, here comes that word. The groove is so precise. Listen how the grooves can be straight ahead or even have a touch of swing. Drummers like this make everyone who play with them sound great.
I can name that tune in four notes.
Try sitting down and playing something the whole world will recognize instantly.
Toto Africa?
Yeah, man.
I can name that tune in one note.
Did you get that?
From Buddy and Vinny's sick technique to Charlie's perfectly placed backbeat. From Gad's deep pocket and innovation to Phil Collins and John Robinson's memorable hooks. From Jeff's finesse and grace to Bernard's simplicity and foundation and everyone in between. These guys are all incredibly different and incredibly special. None better than the next. They all found that thing that makes them unique. And as guitarist Steve Vai says, they are the best at being themselves, not the second-rate version of someone else. All the great drummers in this video and many others that we didn't have time to show found that thing that makes them unique. They all listen to that inspirational voice in their head and heart and follow it. And that's what we all need to find in ourselves. What kind of music inspires you? What kind of players inspire you? Whatever those answers are, go for that and be great at that. And that is what it takes to be a great drummer. At the end of every episode, we have a segment called Hidden Gems, where we tell you about a song, a musician, a producer, etc., that you may or may not know about. This week's Hidden Gem is a drummer that I consider to be one of the finest that ever lived, with one of the deepest, no-nonsense pockets that always played the song perfectly, studio great Mike Baird. Mike played on hundreds and hundreds of records in the 70s, 80s, and 90s, ranging from Seals and Crofts to Donna Summer to Rick Springfield to Al Jarreau to Van Stevenson to Kenny Loggins to Eddie Money to Billy Idol to Hall & Oates and many, many more. Insane consistency, grooves, and attention to song detail. Baird's groove caught the attention of the guys from the band Journey, and after auditioning close to every big name in the business, Baird sat on the throne for the coveted Raised on Radio tour. Here's a clip of Baird grooving hard on that tour. And yes, that's Randy Jackson of American Idol playing bass. If you haven't heard of drummer Mike Baird, I'm proud to have introduced you. Go check out his legacy of work. You won't be disappointed. Well, that brings us to the end of another episode. I think we've successfully cut into, diagnosed, and remedied what it takes to be a great drummer. Nurse, stitch him up. A special thanks this week to producer, writer, and excellent drummer Jaron Sorensen for letting us shoot here at his studio. Go see Jaron play live with Blackhawk or the Outlaws in a city near you. Sumner, take a bow. What? You wanna play a clip of your favorite drummer? All right, go ahead. I'll see you the next time the doctor's in.